My fuck up. I gotta record everything. I'm just standing here, just looking around at the different hairs and stuff, and got one in my hand. This one young guy comes up to me, right up on me, like, this is me, where my jacket is, and he's standing, like, right there. I mean, a few more inches, we could kiss. We could fucking kiss. And he's like, you need help with something? I said, I'm just looking. And he's like, well, why are you looking at me? And then he bumps into my butt and my purse. Uh-uh. Fuck that shit. Let me come up to the front counter. Smiling like it's funny. Where's the manager? Crystal.
Oh, hey, lady, how you doing?
Hey, how you doing?
All right. Good seeing you.
Been going through a lot of hell. Still going through it.
Check out? She get check out.
Not just yet. Which one of y'all is the manager?
Me. Can I help you?
Yeah. I'll talk to you in a second. Okay, this is insane, and I come in here a lot and shop. Okay, I come in here, first I'm looking over at the wigs, but then I didn't notice anybody free to be able to help me with these, so I just grabbed one of these, and I was going to walk over towards where they sit at. And then I go to looking at the Brazilians in the packs, just looking at it and looking at how much they cost. And then the young skinny guy who's working over there, he walks right up to me, like, say for instance, I'm just going to, like, hold this in my arm for a second. Like, say for instance, this right here is me, right? Where the counter is. He walks up to me. Usually if somebody asks, like, if they can help you with something, they'll stand at this distance. He's, like, right up on me, like, can I help you with something? I mean, what, about 2 or 3 more inches and we could have kissed. Mm-hmm. And that made no sense. Excuse me, I need to talk to him. Just to him.
I just told you.
Just to him. Just to him. Just to him. Thank you, sir. So, I'm standing there. Mm-hmm. And why is he pegging me to be recording? Anyways, all right. So, I'm standing there, and he's like right up on me, and he's like, can I help you with something? And we're just that close to where in which we could kiss. So, I'm like, no, I'm just looking around. And then he passes by me, bumping into my bag, my big bag right here, and my butt. Between me and the aisle where the other stuff was behind me. Mm-hmm. Thomas, I'm just trying to see why you looking at me like that. Bumping into me.
Okay, I'm sorry about that.
I mean, that was just
get,
really...
I'll get it. I'm sorry about that, man.
Thank you, because, I mean, that's just really wrong. First he gets physically too close, then all of a sudden he wants
to be
physical.
Well, he's just being helpful, because that's how I tell all the employees.
That close?
Make sure
that close? I've had workers help me, male workers and female workers, and usually they'll stand about, like, say, for instance, if this is me, they'll stand about this distance, whether it be male or female, this distance. He's this distance. Yeah. That makes no sense. And I didn't appreciate that.
Yeah,
especially when I come over here and shop all the time.
Yeah. That's what I'm saying. Sorry about that, but he's a new employee, and he's just trying to be very helpful.
No. There's no just trying it in it. Because it's just as bad as him walking up to a female and grabbing her butt saying, oh, I was just trying to help her out. She seemed a little off balance.
But he didn't touch you, did he?
He bumped into my butt and my bag when he went behind me after standing too close up on me.
Then I can check the cameras and I'll see that if he bumped into you. Mm-hmm. But did he say excuse me?
No.
No, he didn't
not in the least bit. Oh. And then when I'm passing by, he's giving me this sadistic smile like it was funny.
Okay. Okay. I'll check it out. I'll check out the cameras and I'll see if that happened or not.
Yeah, it did.
Well, I'll check the cameras. Yeah. I got plenty of cameras over here.
Okay.
And
well,
you know,
that's good.
They show everything.
Yeah, and I'll get you'll to be the able to see it because, I mean, that's just not even fair, especially when I come over here and shop.
Yeah.
I mean, if you look to the front of the store, I have two suitcases and a cardboard sign. It's obvious. It's already obvious I'm not even in the economic status to be able to shop here, but I still do. Why? Because I'm a female and I still try to be pretty even despite my situation. But I'm spending money that I could barely afford to be able to spend over here. And then all of a sudden I have to be what, accosted by this guy like I'm just nothing. Whether he's new or old or whether he owns this place, he shouldn't do that to me. That's not fair.
And I apologize for that. Do you want to accept that apology or no?
Just as long as something's done.
I'll address it later on. But I can't do it right now. That's, as you can see, we're very busy. But I'll get it addressed. Okay? Other than that, could I help you out with anything?
Just at least helping me feel justified. Because, I mean, that just wasn't even fair. You'll be able to even see on your camera. I mean, at least talking to him right now, briefly. I'm not saying lock him up or shoot him or anything like that. I'm not saying
I'll
that.
Yeah, I'll talk to him. That's what I'm telling you. But I don't talk to him in front of people. I do not do that.
Well,
I respect
him
my
off
employees
to the back.
And I respect my customers.
Yes, I understand. Because when I used to work, they used to do the same thing. Pull people off to the back.
Yeah, I
understand that.
We don't do that.
But at least pull him off right now. So that way, whenever I go back there and have to try on whatever, I don't have to deal with any more meanness or violation. So at least taking him to the back briefly to let him know. Because, I mean, that just makes me feel violated. I'm already a rape victim, aside from being homeless. And then a domestic violence victim. Then a gang stalking victim. How much more do I have to go through?
Yeah, I'm sorry about that, ma'am.
But at least taking him to the back. I understand about the privacy issue about dealing with your employees. Mm-hmm. But at least taking him to the back briefly to let him know.
I'll let him know. I told you I'll address it, ma'am.
Yeah.
But that's all I can do. I can just address
That's okay? Good. Okay.
Okay?
Okay. But I'm going to be trying on Harris, and he's back there. So I'm not trying to
he's an employee. I can't tell him to clock out or go do something else. I can't do that. His
I'm just talking about you addressing
it.
Him before he come back around me with more stuff.
Just you don't speak to him and he won't speak to you.
That's okay? Not.
He
came up to me. I did not call to him. He came up to me. I did not call to him.
I know. But right now, just you don't speak to him and he doesn't speak to you. Okay? If you need any help.
Worth of nothing for a customer.
If you need any help, there's plenty of employees or come find me up front. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, you're welcome.
Hey, do you be helping people out with the wigs?
Yeah.
Okay, so you're busy with her, so I'll wait. I saw about two or three of them. I liked it. I'm gonna go back on this off. I had that one before. I didn't like it all too much. If you're wondering about the hair in my hands, I was just trying stuff out. That's all I'm doing right now, is trying stuff. That was just really uncalled for, and apparently for as long as I'm in the store, I gotta keep on record. Is that fair? No. Yeah. For my safety and security and for my evidence, I have to keep on record instead of letting my phone rest, letting my battery rest, and I could just peacefully focus in on, gee, what would I like? What colors do I like? What styles?
I know, but I just put it good.
لما تقول لي هسه بكي ناس عذرهم لما تشوف ما حد بيشوف تقولوا لها قوما هو اكلتها تقبل كتب المحل مفرد يفتح ترديد
Oh, believe me, if that was Spanish spoken, I'd be able to pick up on it. English off the rip. Whatever language you're speaking, I don't know what it is. I don't speak it. But the fact that I am putting it on YouTube and a whole bunch of people look at my videos, even on my old account that I used to have, I'm quite sure that there would be somebody who'd happily be able to translate what the fuck you just said. Where's that one female? I just looked at this one. I just want to do something different. Even though I was a rape victim. I sought emotional support. So, my out-of-state ex-boyfriend, we were never physically sexual. He didn't come to Louisiana. I didn't go up to where he was up north. Or where he is up north. But we're mostly verbal, emotional, and mental. Why did I date, go back to him and date him after being raped? I have no counseling. I have no counselor. I have no true friends who want to be around to, you know, counsel me or to comfort me or anything. So who else would talk to you 24/7 and listen to what you have to say? A boyfriend. The rape traumatized me so bad, I was afraid of trusting new people. So trying to meet a new guy? I was like, fuck no. Nah. But trying to trust a new guy, I was too afraid to. I kept feeling like anyone who came my way would only want to rape me. So, I started communicating with my exes. And started rehashing on feelings I used to have for him. And bada boom, bada bing, we got back together. But when other people, including family and friends, don't want to be your support, you go and try to look for support any kind of way you could. Well, any kind of way you can. This thing is so disheveled. Yet pretty. I think I like you. Alright, maybe not so much. Fuck. Oh yeah, let me go ahead and do a time and date. Yeah. Where's my other? Oh, it's in my pocket. Third. This is really insane what I have to go through. Mm-hmm. It's really fucked up the shit that I have enough to go through. But I will be starting over.